And we have on the line Patrick Colligan, who is the president of the New Jersey State PBA. Mr. Colligan, hi.
Deminski and Doyle, what's going on, guys?
Hey, what did you want to say about this? I could imagine what it is, but it would be best coming from you.
I don't want to get bleeped out, so I'll be easy on it.
Yeah.
We testified against this bill, and look, there's a lot of reasons why, but I guess the first thing is we pay the most towards our pension, we pay the most towards health care out of any other public employee, and now it's just the cops and firemen being forced into work, you know, living in a town that you know opts into this for 5 years, which you know you can get hired up to age 35 in this business in New Jersey, and there might be a guy that's 28, 30, maybe had military and owns a home somewhere, and now he's going to be forced to uproot a family. It's just a lot of reasons why it's not a good idea. When we testified, I asked the committee, let's give incentives for the officers and firemen to move into the
I
town.
Said Don't that, know. Right, a higher pay rate or something. I was just mentioning that idea.
You know, when your callers talked about a take-home car, you can have, maybe a tax break for the town. You can have, even maybe a civil service advantage on a test for promotions. There were 22 incentives I gave them because when you legislate it, you know, right now under civil service rules, you'll have guys that literally move out a year, you know, literally back U-Haul truck up a year after the requirement is done for civil service.
Yeah, the very day of, yeah.
It's going to be the same thing here with 5 years. And it isn't, you know, Governor Cody's right. You know, 30 years ago, we did live, even amongst, I hate to say it, the mobsters, but the mobsters of 2015, the mobsters, you know, it's a different gang environment.
Yeah.
And things are a lot different than they were when he talked about, you know, living in the inner city. But you got to look at Camden. Camden got rid of the residency requirement. About 85% of their officers don't live in Camden. I've been a cop for 23 years. I have never once responded to a call or handled an investigation and said, oh, I'm not going to work on this as hard because hey, I don't live in this town. I mean, that was just, it was really an offensive statement from the committee that we would work harder somehow because we lived in the town that we work in.
Does that seem to be the only pro of the list of pros and cons for something like this that they offer? They just honestly feel that cops and firefighters will be somehow better at their jobs because they're more invested in the community? Is that really all they have?
The other big point, and I think one of your callers touched on it, was that they wanted to infuse a middle class into some of these cities. Well, you know, I get that point, but again, give the officers and the firemen incentives to move in. It's just a tough pill to swallow with everything else that's happened to us over the last 5 or 6 years. To now have it legislated where we're going to live.
I agree, because, I mean, how invested in a community are you really truly going to feel when you were forced to do it?
That was part of my argument.
Absolutely.
It was the biggest part of our argument. And again, very offended to find out that they think that we're going to, you know, a fireman's going to respond faster if he lives in town. It's just, it's what we do. This isn't a job like, you know, becoming a plumber or an accountant. You become a cop and a fireman because you want to. It's more of a vocation than a job, and you do it because you love it. I mean, there's exceptions out there. I'm not going to pretend that everybody's
right.
But this is not the kind of job that you just say, oh, let me be a cop tomorrow or a fireman. I mean,
it is certainly a calling. All right, hey, we're up against the clock, but Patrick Colligan, president of the NJ State PBA. Thank you very much for calling in. The New Jersey 101.5.